Hi, this is Gopal Kamat and welcome to yet another powerful video in this series of lot of valuable videos on my YouTube channel, that is Get Your Restaurant. Before telling you about today's video, let me just request you, if you haven't already, just press the subscribe button, click the subscribe button and subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon, because we keep on coming up with new and different videos which are related to helping you give lots of information about starting a profitable food business. And today I have a very powerful video for you. Today I am going to dissect and simplify all the different types of food businesses which are working in the market. Most of the time when people come and tell me that they are interested in food business, they want to start a restaurant of their own, they want to start a food business of their own, they are clueless where to start, because there are so many concepts in the market. There are small restaurants, there are big restaurants, there are bars, there are lounges, there are casual dining, there are street shops, there are bakeries, there are coffee shops, there are cloud kitchens, there are home kitchens. What to start? This is one of the biggest question which I get. And people are totally confused, because they don't know which is the right one, which is the wrong one. If they choose if they put their money in a concept and it doesn't work, what should they do? So I have dissected each and everything, and I have simplified in this coming part of the video. I have simplified how to choose the right type of food business for yourself. So before I take you towards the video where I explain to you all the different types of concept, I want you to do one more thing. If you have not yet registered for my free Saturdays workshop, just click the link in the description section, go there, enter your name and email ID. I do a workshop every Saturday at 6 o'clock, where I take you deep into planning your own food business. So we talk about lots of stuff where you come out with a complete plan on starting a successful food business. So if you haven't already, the workshop is free. I don't charge anything for it. Just click the link in the description section and join the workshop, and I will see you live on Saturday. Now enjoy this video and stay cool. Now let's look at different concepts. Let me do a magic trick for you. Let's look at all the different concepts. 3, 2, 1, ta-da! So we have so many concepts to cover, but we will cover it fast. And you don't need to take a snapshot or write it down. I am going to give you the whole presentation, so don't worry. So let's start with, so let me give you a basic drop down of all the concepts: street food shops or small shops, small non-AC restaurants, single cuisine restaurant, modified single cuisine restaurants, cafes, bistros, baristas, quick service restaurants, food trucks. Type awesome in the chat box if you love this in-depth presentation. Food trucks, food carts, bakeries, coffee shop duos, veg, non-veg restaurants and bars, lounges, restos, pubs, bars, casual dining restaurants, fine dining restaurants, highway restaurants, delivery kitchen, dark kitchen, cloud kitchen and home kitchen. So I've covered more or less all the types of concepts which are there in the market. So let's start with street food stall or shop. These type of street food stalls or shops serve all types of people, mostly masses and lower middle class and poor people. The location is in the market, crowded places, nookkads, opposite railway stations and bus stations. Type yes if you are hungry, if you are alone and if you are going somewhere, you know, raste pe vada pav dikh gaya, garam garam nikal rahe, you just go there, you have a vada pav. Type yes if you have had that kind of an experience. Of course, I love street food and I love food, so I've always had it. Location is in the market, crowded place, nookkad, opposite railway stations, bus stand. Menu is simple, local cuisine and pricing is reasonable. Vada pav stalls, bhelwala stalls, Chinese stalls, dosa stalls, sandwich counters, puri bhaji counters, pav bhaji counters. These are all street food stalls or shops. Profits are made on volume. These are basically self-service. One or two people are behind the counter, they are cooking the stuff, they are doing the parcel, or they are serving it in a plate. Size is around 50 square feet to 300 square feet. Budget can be from 1 to 4 lakh rupees.
Yeah. Now we have these small non-AC restaurants. You will find many of these small non-AC restaurants. These are kind of like the upper or the improvised versions of a street food stall or shop. So you'll find them mostly at the same locations as the street food shops. Location is in market, crowded areas, gullies, nookards, opposite railway stations, bus stands. And they are serving mostly all type of people, all the crowd which is moving there. Menu is simple, local cuisine, and pricing is very reasonable. Low-cost thalis like 60 rupees to 100 rupees thalis. Biryanis, pre-plated biryanis, pre-plated pav bhajis, pre-plated chana bhatura, pre-plated puri bhajis and stuff like that. Profits are made again on volume. Service is basic. Service is very, very basic. You might have a tube light and a little bit of painting. That's it. Nothing else. Table, kurchis, bakadas and all are very, very simple. Decor is moderate, not fancy at all. Size is around 500 to 800 square feet. Budget is around 5 to 15 lakh rupees. I am also including the cost of the working capital for 6 months. That's why the budget is around 5 to 15 lakh rupees. Everybody following up till now? Type yes in the chat box. Yeah, great. Thank you so much. Then we will go to single cuisine restaurants. So what I mean by single cuisine restaurants are all the Udipi restaurants of the world, of India or of the world, all the Punjabi restaurants. So, sorry, any restaurant which is serving the local cuisine or authentic cuisine can be categorized under single cuisine. Udipi restaurant, you might have gone to Anand Bhavan, you might have gone to Saravan Bhavan, you might have gone to any other restaurant which is serving. Saravan Bhavan is kind of like a posh thing, but basic non-AC restaurant serving middle class and higher middle class floating population. Location is again in the market and residential areas alike. Menu is authentic cuisine and pricing is reasonable. 50, 60, 70 rupees, 80 rupees per plate and all. Serves lunches, dinners, thalis, a la carte menu. A la carte means a plate-wise menu. Pricing, mostly Udipi and other cuisine. If you go to Amritsar, you will get restaurants which are serving paratha, dahi paratha, which are serving ghee paratha, which are serving chole bature, which are serving rajma chawal. Type yes if you have had any experience in Udipi kind of a restaurant or a single cuisine restaurant. So these are basically authentic restaurants which are serving food at a very, very economical rate, and they are making money in volume, on volume rather. And the basic decor is pretty basic. Little bit posh than the small non-AC restaurants, but not very, very exclusive. Size is around 600 to 1000 square feet. Budget can be around 15 to 25 lakh rupees, even more, depending on the size of the restaurant. Now we will move to the modified or the improvised versions of a single cuisine restaurant. So most of these restaurants are semi-AC restaurants. In Mumbai, we have the Shetty restaurants. Even in other places, you might be having Shetty restaurants where half of the restaurant is AC and half of the restaurant is non-AC. Type yes if you have gone to that kind of a restaurant. So these are basically semi-AC restaurants serving weekday population, weekday floating population they are attracting in their non-AC section, as well as weekend family customers and posh customers in their AC section. So this is kind of like a hybrid of single cuisine restaurant and a posh restaurant. Can you guys understand this? Type yes in the chat box. So earlier, they were only single cuisine restaurants. But as I told you yesterday, when the need converts into want, people want. So need is basically going to a restaurant and having food and filling your stomach. But want is that you want to sit in an AC restaurant. You want to have pizza, pasta, burger with your kid. You want to have. So it's kind of like a luxury thing. And this is kind of like a necessity thing. So single cuisine restaurant mostly are serving necessary customers, people who have the necessity to just fill their stomach. But modified single cuisine restaurants are giving that extra luxury so that they can charge more, they can make more money, and they can target another slice of the customers in the marketplace. So, location is in residential areas, market areas, easily accessible for floating as well as residential population. Can you find this pattern? All the types of food businesses which I am talking about, the location is a highly potential location. Type yes in the chat box if you understand this. Nowhere have I written that your place should be in a Kona, Kopcha and this and that. Because location, as I have told you yesterday, I think we covered it yesterday. Yeah, yesterday is a very, very powerful deciding factor whether your food business is going to be a hit or it can be a flop. So, semi-AC restaurants, semi-AC serving restaurants, weekdays, putting population, as well as weekend family customers. It is like a double thing. It has an AC and a non-AC. Serves masses, middle classes and higher middle classes. Location is in residential areas, market areas alike, easily accessible for floating as well as residential customers. I am sure most of you might have visited this place on weekends, maybe on a Saturday or a Sunday. It might be a non-AC and AC restaurant along with a bar where you go and you chill, you have some non-veg, you have a beer or a whiskey and you come and, you know, have a nice week. So that happens because it is a modified cuisine restaurant. Menu is multi-cuisine and pricing is above average. Serves lunch, dinner, thali, a la carte menu alike. Medium price, service is good and decor is kind of elegant. It is on the, now we are moving towards the top end of the pyramid. Is everybody understanding this? Type yes in the chat box. So as we are moving on the top side of the pyramid, the decor will start getting more and more exclusive. And you will have AC, you will have good service, you will have well-dressed staff, you will have well-mannered service. So budget is around 60 to 90 lakh rupees. It might go above that also. But 60 to 90 lakh is the basic budget for a modified single cuisine restaurants. So some of the times the modified single cuisine restaurants also have a banquet attached, because the banquet serves as a place for people to do some small events and activities also. Let me put it here. Sometimes has banquet hall attached. Okay. So that is cool. So sometimes, you know, you the cross-selling is done when the customers who are coming there to have a weekend food might require a small 50 people hall to do their engagement ceremony or to do their birthday party or to do their kind of like an anniversary or a get together or stuff like that. So they use the same place because they have fallen in love with the food and the decor. So it's kind of like they are targeting both. It's a banquet hall also and it's a restaurant also. So cafes, bistros and baristas, mostly AC, serving teens, couples and family customers, serves middle class and higher middle class and above. Location is in or near malls, residential areas, near colleges, universities. The target clientele now has changed from a little bit older generation to a younger generation. Pricing is medium to high, serves lattes, coffees, tea, pizza, pasta, burgers, sandwiches, sizzlers and all. And service is good, decor is elegant. And size is around 800 to 1000 square feet. Budget can be around 20 to 30 lakh rupees. Now we move towards the newest baby of the food industry. Everybody, you might have heard, type yes if you have heard this. Arre, mere ko QSR kholne ka hai. Mere ko QSR. Lot of people don't know the definition of a QSR. I don't mean to boast. I'm just giving you a fun fact. So QSR stands for quick service restaurants. Serving middle class and higher middle class. Location is in or near residential areas, near colleges, classes, universities. These type of outlets serves combos, fast food, pizzas, burgers, pastas. The menu is comparatively pretty precise and most of the food is cooked there or finished there, but it is pre-cooked and the food has been sent from a central kitchen. So pricing is medium to high. They have all the layers. They have an attracting factor and they have a profitizing factor, which I'm going to cover on the last day, by the way. This is a golden strategy, which I'm going to cover. You should have a product which attracts your customers and you should have a product which lets you make maximum profits from that customer. So these type of QSRs have a medium to high pricing structure. Usually big chain of outlets, they have a big chain of outlets served by central kitchen, where pre-prepared food is finished in the QSRs, but it is stored one day in advance from the central kitchen. Budget is around 30 to 60 lakh rupees for a QSR. I am not including the cost of the central kitchen over here. Pre-preparation is usually sent from kitchen and finishing is done in the QSRs. If you're talking about pizzas from Domino's, the bread is already ready. It is just the bread and the toppings are put and they are sent through a conveyor oven and they are finished and they are sent. Usually all MNC chains of restaurants fall under this category. Size is around 1000 to 3000 square feet. Budget can go from 50 lakh rupees to 3 crore rupees. If you talk about a McDonald's, although it is a restaurant, but technically it is kind of like a, it's kind of like a modified QSR. But the cost, the investment is more than 3.5 crores for that. So you can start a small QSR for 50 lakh rupees also. Everybody following this? Thank you so much. So now we come to food truck. A lot of people are interested in starting a food truck. Serves working class population and floating population. Most of the time, food trucks are stationed or they are parked in front of a ST stand of a railway station in the middle of a central business district. What I mean by that is in the middle of a office area so that afternoon everybody comes down and has type yes if you understand this. A lot of time in front of a park, in front of a where highly moving population of crowd comes in and out. So parked in office areas, central locations, opposite stations, bus stops, etc. Menu is local and pricing is reasonable. Serve snacks, a la carte menu, pricing item mostly Indian and mixed cuisine. And profits are made on volume, self-service. Budget is around 15 to 25 lakh rupees. If you want to buy a brand new food truck, it itself might cost you around 12 to 15 lakh rupees. And then again, the cost of all the other stuff will include. Then we come to bakeries and coffee shop duos. Mostly AC serving teens, couples and family customers. Serves middle class and higher middle class and above. Location is near malls, residential areas, near colleges, classes, universities. Mediums priced, these concepts serve medium priced baked food products as well as coffees. Items along with beverages serving lattes, coffees, pizza, pasta, burgers, patties, sandwiches and all. My mouth has started watering. And service, self-service and decor is basic. Size is around 500 to 800 square feet. And budget is around 15 to 25 lakh rupees. Now we move towards the major players of the food business. These are the veg, non-veg bars and restaurants. All the Shetty bars or all the, I know I call it Shetty bars, but we lot of Kamats have also opened bars. Lot of other people have also opened bars. But at one time, majority, I'm talking about Mumbai, majority of the people who were owning bars were Shettys. That's why the name comes as a Shetty bar. So type yes if you have visited one or the other kind of a bar. So mostly non-AC or semi-AC serving above 30 years or more. So these are kind of like 30 years or more. These are old bars or these are basically old brands and they are serving customers who are 30 years and above or family customers. Most of them have regular customers. So a lot of time people who are already doing a job in the evening, they will come because the job is very stressful. They will go to their regular bar. They know the waiter by name. The waiter knows them by name. Oh, sir, beto, sir. Literally, the waiter knows what that guy is going to drink and how much he's drinking. He might be having a quarter. He might be having one peck. He might be having two pecks. And what kind of snacks he will be having. It is what we call as chakna. So is he going to have a kaleji fry? Is he going to have chana? Is he going to have a pomfret fry? So this level of loyalty, type yes if you know or if you are a loyal customer of one kind of a bar. So that level of loyalty and that level of comfort that bar has serves middle class and higher middle class population and above. Location is near residential areas, offices and work areas and major travel routes while coming from. It might be near his house or it might be near his office. He will have that one or two pegs, say bye-bye, pay the bill, go home. His wife has cooked nice food. He will cook, eat that food and then take a chill pill. So that is basically his regular routine to de-stress. He might not go every day, but he might go once in a week or twice in a week when the major stress is happening. and medium to high priced, serving liquor with veg and non-veg. Decor is elegant, cozy and comfortable. Have you seen these bars which have kind of like dim lighting? Type yes if you agree. Dim lighting, very, very cozy. Thoda sa ghazal chal raha hai baju mein. You know, and a nice ghazal and people are enjoying a nice peg of whatever they are having. So high emphasis on service and guest relationship. Size is around 1200 to 1800 square feet. Budget can be around 60 to 90 lakh rupees. I know I have kept this pricing a little lower, but it can go around, it might wobble for around 20, 30 lakhs up and down. So then we come to the newest kid on the block. These type of concepts are a regular hit from the past 5 years. These are the lounge bars, pubs or resto bars. Type yes if you have gone to or if you have seen this kind of a concept. So mostly AC serving above 20 to 45 years, attracting small to large group of customers. So these are basically addressing people who have started recently earning. They might be people from the IT, they might be people from the BPO, they might be people from the banking sector. And these are young generation people who have recently started drinking, recently started partying. They have been independent and they have started earning and they have started enjoying their life. So serves population working in IT, BPO. So the socials of the world, the TBSC of the world, or the BKC Dive of the world, all these types of concepts are basically lounges and bars, resto bars and all. Serves population working in IT, BPO, engineering, banking, and other elite industries. Location is near offices and commercial areas or near posh residential areas. Most of them, type yes if you know one or two of these concepts. Most of them serve liquor with offers and make up their margins on specialized food. Decor is rustic or themed with emphasis on recreation and partying. So what I mean by that is, so let me cover one first, the point before this. Most of them serve liquor with offers. So type yes if you have seen 1+1 free, Monday afternoon free, happy hours, or you know, beer at 3 rupees, 4 rupees or something like that. And you know, and so the what these guys are doing is liquor they are buying in bulk. So they are getting a lot of discounted liquor, or they are getting a lot of cases free on 10 cases and all, and they are passing on that discount to the customers so that the customer comes in the outlet, and then they sell them food, which is also reasonably priced, by the way. But more food is had by them because these guys are drinking, guys and girls, and then they make money on the food. Decor is rustic, kind of like, you know, lounge, very, very rustic decor, themed, and recreation is on party. You might be having a dance floor, you might be having a karaoke night, you might be having something on a Friday night, a rock party or something like that. High emphasis on customer loyalty. Size is around 3,000 to 8,000 square feet. Budget is around 2 to 5 crores. This is a beautiful concept, and it has got, it's very, very exciting to run that kind of concept. Then we come to the casual dining restaurants. Mostly AC outlets serving individuals, couples or family restaurants. Most of them are multi-cuisine serving specialized food. Serves higher middle class and above. Location is near commercial areas and residential areas alike. Medium to high priced service liquor. So medium to high priced, they serve liquor and veg, non-veg food. Decor is exclusive. So it's like one notch below fine dine, but decor is posh, it is exclusive, and high emphasis on guest and relationship. So ideally, if you along with your husband or your girlfriend or boyfriend, whoever, you are going to a restaurant to celebrate your birthday or to celebrate your anniversary, you might go to something like a fine dine restaurant or a casual restaurant. Type yes if you understand this. Size is around 2,000 to 4,000 square feet. Budget is around 1.5 crores and more. Yeah, I hope everybody is following this. Then we move to the top notch of the restaurant, that is the fine dine restaurant, ultra specialized restaurant serving elite individual, couples and family customers. Most of them are multi-cuisine restaurants, you know, the authentic Chinese restaurant, authentic Japanese restaurant, authentic Mexican restaurant, authentic American restaurant, authentic European restaurant. So most of them are multi-cuisine restaurants, specialized food, serves higher middle class and rich people. Location is near commercial areas and residential areas alike and in five-star hotels. High-priced food and liquor serving veg, non-veg food. Decor is exclusive and they keep on renovating every three, four years. High emphasis on service and guest relationship. Regular elite customers, size is around 4,000 to 8,000 square feet. Budget is around 4 crore and above. There they have got very, very strong, loyal customers. Now we come to the highway restaurants. Why is this not opening? So now we come to the highway restaurant. I showed you my restaurant, which is the Kamats Govinda Garden restaurant. It is a highway restaurant. Mostly semi-AC outlets serving highway travelers. Most of them are mixed cuisine restaurants. Located in between two locations and serves as a breakpoint. Usually the location is in between 2 hours of reach. So ideally, if the destination is around 3 to 4 hours, you'll have a restaurant exactly in the middle of that location, wherein people from this side and people from that side will come and have a break at that restaurant. Medium to high priced food served. Decor is elegant and major emphasis on fast service. Size is around 2000 to 4000 square feet. Budget is around 50 to 90 lakh rupees. Now we have come to the newborn babies of the hotel restaurant business, or rather the food business. These two concepts are pretty new. Although we had restaurants which were delivering food earlier, there was no efficiency, no accountability, no apps or something like that. So delivery kitchens have taken the whole food business by storm. Everybody and anybody is talking about opening a delivery kitchen. Located in industrial premises and delivering to homes and offices. You don't require a very, very strong real estate which is faced on the road, which is very, very ideally located for a cloud kitchen. You can hire a place in an industrial location which has less rent as possible, because your food, you cannot see a cloud kitchen. That's why it is called as a cloud kitchen. Cloud kitchen, why is it called? Is because the food is ordered on an app and the app is set in the cloud. That's why it is called kind of like a cloud kitchen. So mostly takes orders from delivery apps and have their own team to deliver or tie up with logistical courier companies. Serves veg, non-veg food to all homes and offices. Medium to high priced food, packaged food delivered. No decor, no high priced real estate, only food manufacturing and supplying. It is kind of like a food factory. And multiple brands under one kitchen. You can have 10, 15, 20 brands in one kitchen and remove food from that. Heavy emphasis on branding and marketing. And budget is around 30 to 70 lakh rupees. Now we come to home kitchen. Home kitchens. So any type of food which is cooked or prepared or sold from a home kind of makes it a food which has come out from a home kitchen. So food cooked and supplied from home, mostly taken orders from personal contracts or from their own network or delivery apps, or have their own team of delivery or tie up with logistical courier companies. So now, earlier, a lot of my students used to ask me, we are not listed on Zomato, we are not listed on Swiggy, what should we do for deliveries? So we came up with an idea where you can cook the food, you can take orders from your network, you can advertise your food on Facebook. And once you get the order, you tie up with online courier companies like VFast, like Porter, or like any other Dunzo and all. And you sell them, you tell them to deliver the food in 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, 3 kilometer. Whatever is the charges of the delivery, you can maybe include it in the cost of the food, or you can tell the customer to pay it extra. So that is the turnaround, or that is the idea which we came up, and it is killing it for a lot of my students. So serves veg, non-veg food to all homes, offices. All the dabba walas are basically home kitchen. Type yes in the chat box. The dabba walas, which are everyday dabba wala, is coming from a home kitchen. So this is a highly unorganized type of a concept, which is making a lot of money, but people don't. It is not visible because it is not organized. You don't have a home kitchen association or a home kitchen sanghatna or something like that. So serves veg, non-veg food to all homes and offices. They do mini bulk caterings like birthday parties, anniversaries, or get-togethers and stuff like that. Medium to high-priced food delivered. No decor, no highly priced real estate, only food manufacturing and supplying from home. So one to two brands under in one kitchen. You can the home kitchen, there is a little bit of disadvantage wherein you cannot scale as compared to a cloud kitchen, but then the costs are very, very low. So ideally, if any of you is starting and you are confused, I would heavily recommend you to start a home kitchen, because that gives you the opportunity to adjust your concept, that gives you the opportunity to create, to understand in very less investment whether this business is for you or no.
Yeah. Have you registered for my free workshop? Yeah, I do a free workshop every Saturday at 6 o'clock in the evening. Each week I come online and I help you to reach your goals and plan out your exact type of food business, any kind of food business it might be. The online workshop is free and it is happening this weekend on Saturday at 6 p.m. So if you have not yet registered, just click the link in the description section, go there, enter your name, email ID, sign up, and most importantly, be there live and we can work on your successful food business. This is Gopal Kamath signing off. Be there this Saturday. See you this Saturday. Bye-bye.